Hey, Petey Hamilton coming at ya with another video. Oh yeah, we making a beer kit today, kit and kilo. It's from a Superstore, a pale ale beer kit. Should be really good. yeah, buddy. All right, here we go. Well, here we go. making a beer batch. I think it's a pale ale from a Superstore kit. Here we go. Carboys all. Well, my beer barrel is cleaned, ready to go, sanitized. Just about to add the sugar right now. Here we go.
Wash your hands. It's been soaking in the sink here for 20 minutes, hot water. Everything's clean, ready to go. Yeah, you buy it at the Superstore. Drain all the contents in your barrel. Look at it split easy. Fill this up with some hot water. Stirring the can here. Mm-hmm. new technique. It's just faster, easier. You boil 1 kilogram of sugar or dextrose into, I don't know, gallon and a half of water. You add it to your barrel. There we go. Just lick a soup. Easy peasy. Lemon squeezy.
Here we go.
Clean towel. Hygiene is very important. And stir it. Bleach, rinse it really good. Sanitize it with star sand, properly diluted. Spray it in there or shake it around. Let it sit there for a couple minutes. And then that's how you clean this. And it's ready to go. That's before this step I just did. It's pretty simple. Make sure it's all stirred really good because it's like a syrup, molassy. Oh, you could smell it. If you had some smell of it, it would be really awesome. Smells really hoppy. See here. What I like to do is like to tip it, then you can see the bottom. Oh yeah, a little bit. A little bit still on the bottom, I can see. Get some water boiling here. I'm trying another thing also here. Scrape the bottom too hard. Again, it needs scratching, and scratching leads to infection, and infection leads to a bad batch of beer. When you boil a pot of water, it kills off the chlorination in the water, and our water is a little chlorinated. But I'm too cheap to buy a spend $8 of water for water. No, it's free. Simple batch, very easy. next water.
Here we go, back at ya. Adding some more hot water. Here, let's see. Let's get you in there. Some hot water. Adding some cold water. Doing about a 50-50 split, boiled water and tap water. Trying to improve the taste. Make sure there's no bacteria. She's almost ready. Got about 14 liters. Got to bring it up to 19 liters for my keg. Now I'll make about 20.
Maybe they'll go for a full 23 because we got a growler to fill and another 1.5 liters container to fill. So more beer. Temperatures, some in the hot, some in the cold zones. Try not to scratch the container. longer until the temperature comes down at 70 degrees or so. Oh yeah, it's warm. Because we used all that boil water. Here we go, last part. Gonna test the temperature. Should be around 70-ish. I think as high as 78. Don't wanna go any higher than that. I think 70, well, I'll say 76, you know. Seven still. Two of them. Back in a bit. Okay, I'm hoping the beer is cool enough.
It's taking a long time.
Okay. Sanitize. Still too warm. Pitch in the east.
I'm back. That's there it is. There it is. Just pitched the yeast. The beer's day later. This is day later. And it's bubbling. Yeast is working good. I had to short wait a long time, wasn't it? I had to wait, oh, good, almost 2 hours. for the water cool down to around 80 degrees. That's about the maximum we want it, around 80, 81, no higher than that. So, it's yeast, and we'll see in about 7 days. After the fermentation stops, we can keg it. I'm making a video for that. Should be interesting. And I can't wait to taste it. Smells really good. Back at ya. Petey Hamilton coming at ya. Make sure to like and subscribe. All that little touch, tip. All that stuff, you know. Helps me out. Hey, talk to you later. See you soon.